in the year of our Lord 2015. How are you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. And it is indeed 2 for Tuesday. You know what that means. 2 beers, 2 hunks, 2 babes, 2 songs, 2 trivia questions, 2 instruments of the day, 2 pets of the day, 2 vehicles of the day, 2 beers of the day. Did I already say that? Shit, I don't know and I don't care. And a whole lot of fun. And today's unofficial sponsor of our show is my good friend, Rob Johnson of CompuTune. Rob, this is going to be a pretty badass New England edition of Beer and Song of the Day today. And you're a New Englander, you're a fellow masshole like me from Taunton, Massachusetts, you live in. You and your better half, Stephanie, total sweetheart that I've known my entire life. Rob is a computer genius, computer repairs over at CompuTune. There's his contact information. Hit him up, folks. Rob's a big fan of Beer and Song of the Day and a former Real Hunk of the Day on Beer and Song of the Day and a former Fan of the Week winner as well. And Rob, my computer restarts on its own every day, and I don't know why. Don't know what's up with it, so I could use your help, bro. All right? So there you go. Well, let's bust out the official New England Patriots beer consumption apparatus. Yeah. That's a full British pint size one, which this is not. How about a little bit of Shipyard Pumpkinhead? This stuff is phenomenal. Where'd I get it? Filo Liquors, of course. Only 4.5% alcohol by volume, below average of strength, definitely well above the average of flavor. This stuff is incredible out of Portland, Maine. Maine used to be part of Massachusetts in 1820. Remember that. Private winning apparatus, prop technique. Here we go. 45 degree end right at the big assumption apparatus, right on the keyboard, because I'm sad damn good, I've supposed to drop yet, never will. Of course, it takes two for Tuesday theme song. Marvin Gaye, Kim Weston, 1965. Great song, great duo. Cheers the bears, all you pros say Germany by the Danger Man. Oh, God. This may be the best pumpkin beer around. Seriously. Big solid A-plus all the way. This stuff is unbelievably good. My good friend Chris May over at Filo Liquors. Yeah, you were right, brother. Alright. A lot of birthday shout-outs for today. And right off the bat. Now, if she wasn't carrying her awesome lesser house baby, Brandon and Jen Vesper. Now, Jen Vesper, an absolutely gorgeous sweetheart of a lady and a former real baby today on Beer and Song of the Day. She's getting spoiled rotten by her awesome husband, Brandon, right now. I know because they're an amazing couple, and I did their wedding ceremony February 8th, 2014. Wow. It's already been that long. Well, anyway, Jen, if you weren't carrying a baby, I know what you'd be doing right now. You'd be drinking adult beverages legally with me right here, right now. Happy 21. Lots of fun, Jen. Living down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma, pretty much the same damn state. An absolute sweetheart, very dear friend of mine. Much love to you, Jen. But hey, as soon as you have your baby, then, a short time later after that, especially if you're breastfeeding. I don't know if you're breastfeeding or not. You know, but if you are, can't be drinking these yet. That's all I know. I wouldn't know. I've never breastfed a baby before. But hey, it's all good. Happy milestone birthday, Jen. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you, my dear. And Brandon, former real hunk of the day on Beer and Song today. You better be spoiling her rotten. Take it from the love, doctor. I know what I'm talking about. Happy wife makes for a happy life. All right, next on the list. My man Guido. Do I have a booger in my nose? No, it's just a light. It's a glare. Shoo. Sorry, folks, I had to make sure. I don't want a booger hanging under my nose while I'm doing a show. Speaking of boogers, the Baltimore Ravens remind me of a bunch of boogers there, Dennis Guido Guidus. Well, brother, you're an awesome guy, a true Maryland guy, so you should be a Baltimore Ravens fan. And I know you were pissed off when that douchebag Bob Irsay stole your Colts in the middle of the night back in 1984. That was some bullshit right there. Moved them to Indianapolis. Indianapolis deserved a football team. But you don't steal a team that's supported heavily by a city like Baltimore. Shame on you, Bob Irsay. God, I need to pee on his grave. But anyway, I digress. Guido, happy birthday, my brother from another moon. Badass crew dog. Then I know from exotic Japan, a great leader of men, women, and it. And Guido, always chatting with you about sports. Awesome stuff. You're a big-time Baltimore Orioles fan as well, as you should be. And, brother, they're looking as bad as my Red Sox now. What's up with that shit? But, hey, you know what? Happy birthday nonetheless, man, because you're an awesome guy and a fellow beer connoisseur like me. Hope you all have an awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Guido, I want you to post up your birthday beer, okay? Next on the list, speaking of badass crew dogs, this guy's an abso-freaking-lute legend. My man Joel Rich, badass crew dog that I know from jolly old England, a high-working man, a great man, awesome guy. And Joel, happy birthday, my man. And brother, how you doing? Hope you're doing well. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969, minus the acid. Miss you, buddy. Been a little bit since I've heard from you. But hey, a big cheers of beers to you, my brother. Next on the list, my good friend, Becky Bond. Longtime fellow Mafia on the old Mafia Wars. Becky Bond, happy birthday. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And always great. We help each other out on the Mafia Wars. We get stronger so that we can crush the opposition. It's a lot of fun, but nobody gets hurt for real. Well, Becky, happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Gotta get these shout-outs moving. Got a lot of birthday shout-outs, a lot of celebrity birthdays, and a ton of this day in history. Next on the list, my good friend, Andrew Thompson, a more recent addition to the Mafia Wars crew. Awesome guy, no doubt about it. Andrew, what's going on? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Happy birthday to you. Hope you're living it up. Hope you're living large. And brother, hope you have a wicked awesome day, and celebrate well, and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, longtime mafioso, I believe even a Farmville player as well back in the day. Jan Crew, or is it Jan? I think it's Jan Crew. A wonderful mafia on the old Mafia Wars. And Jan, happy birthday, my friend. And how you doing? Hope you're doing well. Always appreciate the help on the Mafia Wars. Having some computer problems lately with it. As soon as they get fixed, I will be back on Mafia Wars every day. I miss it. I'll be back. It's gotta happen. And Jan, happy birthday, my friend, and a big hearty cheers and beers to you. Next on the list, celebrating a milestone birthday, a badass crew dude that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana, pretty much the same damn state, my man, Derek Reardon. Derek, dude, the perfect age, 25, man alive, awesome stuff right there. That's right. And Derek, dude, you're the perfect age. You can rent the car from the airport. Your insurance goes down. You can already... squeeze me. Ooh, that hurt. You can already drink adult beverages, and you can already go to triple X-rated porn movies. Yeah. But Derek, I know you're going on a cruise pretty soon to good old Mexico. Brother, have a lot of fun. You're going to enjoy it. You're going to be approved to go. You'll be good to go. Awesome stuff. Congratulations, my man. And, dude, hey, Viva la Mexico! Hey, I don't know. Whatever. Happy birthday, brother. And party high and enjoy. The perfect day is 25, and what a way to celebrate. Going to Mexico, you badass mamma jamma. All right. All right, next birthday. She's not on the old Facebook right now, but her awesome husband Randy, my good friend Randy Singletary, a computer genius, walking brain of a man that I know from jolly old England. Him and his gorgeous better half, Bridget Singletary. Bridget's a former real baby today on Bearded Song of the Day, I might add. And Bridget's getting spoiled rotten by Randy right now. I know you are. Randy, Bridget, I miss you two so much. And Bridget, happy birthday, my dear. And from the love doctor to you, hey, I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Get spoiled, Randy. Make it happen. You're an awesome guy. And Bridget, hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list. I know she's married, and I don't remember what her last name is now. But I knew it was Jennifer Dowling. Long time ago. Martha's Vineyard Reach High School class of 1995. From the greatest town in the world, Vineyard Haven, Massachusetts. Martha's Vineyard Island. And Jennifer Dowling. I know I had you on the old MySpace. I haven't found you on the old Facebook. I went to look for you, see if you're there. But happy birthday, and I hope this message gets to you. Got a lot of friends back home on the island. And I'm sure if you're on the old Facebook, they're friends with you. So Jennifer Dowling, I never forgot your birthday. I didn't need Facebook to remember it. Known it since the day I met you. Well over 2 decades ago. Jennifer Dowling, whatever your last name is now, I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Final birthday of the day goes to my good friend, Mark Maceo. I've known Mike since the first day of kindergarten. Thursday, September 7th, 1978. Like me, Mike Maceo is a final same graduate of Martha's Vineyard Reach High School class of 1991, the best same graduating class in history of mankind, womankind, and it kind. Hell yeah. And Mike, I had you on your MySpace. Haven't found you on the old Facebook. Don't know if you're there or not. But man, I'd love to hear from you. Missed the hell out of you big time. And also from the greatest town in the world, Vineyard Haven, Massachusetts. That's right. And Mike, happy birthday, brother. I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Miss you big time. And a big hearty cheers and beers to you. Folks, let Mike know. I hope he's doing well. Love to hear from him. Same for Jennifer Dowling as well. All right. So, with that said, we've got ourselves a couple trivia questions. We've got ourselves... we have ourselves... a shout out coming up later on the show, because our vehicles of the day are very special. Hang tight, folks. I didn't get a chance to see if somebody met the deadline on Beer and Song of the Day for either of the trivia questions. Last I had checked a few hours ago, nobody had gotten either one right, but there were some good guesses out there for one of the questions. So hang tight, let this pull up. We are up to 2,110 likes. Because a very dear friend of mine got me 3 new likes on the old Facebook. And she's getting a shout out today because... The reason why? Because the vehicles of the day are hers. I'm not going to reveal her name yet. Good things come to those who wait. That's right. So nobody got the trivia questions, folks. That's what it looks like. Boy, there were some good guesses on one of them. Alright, so first question comes to you from my good friend, Justin Dimmitt. You know that name. You love that name. The guy's amazing. A true friend of mine and a great Masonic brother. Justin Dimmitt of Prosper. Facebook.com/LLA Prosper. All one word. Folks, if you ain't following that page, that's a damn shame. You need to follow that page. You don't have to like Star Trek to follow that page. The guy does all kinds of stuff. And man, does he get amped up for football season. Even though he despises my beloved New England Patriots. That's okay. He's a true, legit, no bull, wicked hardcore Colts fan. And I'd hang out with him over a fair weather Patriots fan any day of the week and twice on Sunday. He doesn't like Roger Goodell either. We all know that Roger Goodell should have been swallowed. We get that. Justin Dimmitt, this is the trivia question that you submitted. Who is the only Star Trek character to be ranked as one of Internet Movie Database's top 50 TV dads. Bonus points if you can name his ranking on said list. Folks, it was Benjamin Sisko. Benjamin Sisko, phenomenal African-American actor. And he was ranked number 50. Top 50 TV dads. I didn't even know. Never correlated Star Trek and television fathers. But Benjamin Sisko, awesome guy. Justin Dimmitt, dude, live long and prosper, brother. Great trivia question. Thank you. You know what? I'll drink to you. Our other trivia question. Ted Cassidy played Lurch. You know, you rang. In the Addams Family from 1964 to 1966. How tall was he in real life? There were some good guesses out there, folks. But it was actually 6'9" tall. 6'9", 81 inches. This guy was a towering man indeed. Ted Cassidy, yeah. So you know what? Drink to the late, great Ted Cassidy. Sadly passed away in January 1979, much too young, age of 46. excuse me. Had heart failure. I died during surgery. So he had heart troubles. Very sad. Empty his brain cells of an average. Los Angeles Lakers fan. Got a cure for that. Got a backup. Sam Adams Octoberfest, one of my all-time favorites. My favorite Octoberfest still to this day is the first one I ever had. I love this stuff. It's 5.3% of exquisite wicked awesomeness, slightly above average in strength. Of course, it's out of Boston, Massachusetts. Hearty and smooth with a deep malt complexity and roasty sweetness. I'm a sweet guy. I like sweet beer. Probably running out brass pump technique. Here we go. My wife's making an incredible chicken salad for dinner tonight. I'm excited. 45 degree anger right into the big assumption apparatus right over the keyboard because I'm just that damn good. Have a spill drop yet? Never have, never will. Good thing it was empty. Cheers, beers, all you pro said Germany compiles to stay in Japan. Perfection. A plus all the way, undoubtedly. Wow. All right. Did I get through all the birthdays? Yes, I did. I got through all the shout-outs except for one. And that last shout-out is right here, right now. And then the two songs of the day are dedicated to her vehicles. You'll hear them later. My good friend, I knew her as Mindy Rue. I met her over 20 years ago. She's a fine outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Ridge High School class of 1996. She's drop-dead gorgeous, total sweetheart. We talk almost every day, chat it up. And this is your vehicle, Black Betty. You just traded it in. Black Betty, bam-a-lam. Ram jam, bam-a-lam. Black Betty, Jeep Patriot, beautiful automobile. You traded it in. I know, you were sad to let it go. That thing did you well. Black Betty, yeah. Mindy names her vehicles. That's what us massholes do. Our vehicles, we love our vehicles, so we give them names. In fact, our new vehicle, well, Mindy's new vehicle is Lucy, 2010 Ford Explorer. It is an Explorer, right? Not a Ford Escape. I think it's Ford Explorer. Ah, shit, I don't know. I don't know these new vehicles. Oh, wait, it is a Ford Escape. It says Escape on there. Ha! 2010 Ford Escape. Lucy! This is Lucy. 2010 Ford Escape. Have you noticed that on these vehicles? She supports fire departments and police departments. Oh, yes. She does. She loves those that serve their people. Firemen, policemen, military folks, all branches. Awesome stuff. Mindy, I love people like you. You are absolutely méchant genie. French for wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm tagging to meet. Oh, Canada, indeed. God used to love doing my names up north, and I do it on Baron Song Day every single day of the week. Beanie. Wicked pisser. That's right. Cape Cod cooler. Keeps your brewskis freaking cool colder. That's right. So there you go. There you go, Mindy. Just for you, sweetheart. Boston Red Sox. Yeah. All right, so folks, that's your vehicle of the day on Baron Song Day. Miss and Mindy, much love to you. You're going to love today's songs of the day because they're dedicated to your vehicles. In the meantime, we need to bring out today's instruments of the day. And I got to double check my notes on there because our first one is actually the big man, Ted Cassidy. Look at this guy. You rang? Ted Cassidy's Raven. Look at that big old bird, blackbird, Raven. Hey, there you go there, Dennis Guidus, Guido, cousin Guido. Raven, like your Baltimore Ravens, a.k.a. douchebags. I can't stand Terrell Thugs. He is a waste of life and an ugly son of a bitch to boot. Oh, he makes me look good. I'm horrifying. Ah, shit. I used the wrong picture. That's the Raven picture. That's the one I wanted to use. That is your pet of the day on vehicle and Beard and Song of the Day. Man, I am screwing this up now. Oh, screw it. So we got the instrument of the day, Ted Cassidy's piano, the first one, and the first pet of the day. Ted Cassidy's Raven. Why not? Because Cousin Guido, I know you. You're a Ravens fan. Why not a Raven as a pet of the day? You deserve it, brother. You know what? I drink to you.
And then,
all right, I like this. I think you will too. Because we've got a young lady by the name of Tara Jolie. Jolie, J-O-L-E. And she's got an instrument of the day. It's a microphone. And look at her. Ah, little people are cool too. She can sing like nobody's business. Tara Jolie, a cutie indeed. Her microphone. Why? Why not? And then her pet of the day, a rat. Ugh, I don't like rats. Rats get whacked where I come from. But some people like them as pets. I can promise you this, we will never have a pet rat in Casa de Love Goddess. I guarantee that. Not a pet rat. If a rat ever shows up, it'll be dead. Blasted full of holes. Look like Swiss cheese. That's the only cheese that rat's ever going to get, a Swiss cheese, when it gets holes drilled in it. But yeah, so Tara Jolie's rat. Your other pet of the day on Baron Song of the Day. Folks, it is time for our first hunk of the day, isn't it? It sure is. You know what? Let's go ahead and bring out, you bring Ted Cassidy, an absolute legend, 6'9", absolute badass, the original Lurch from the Addams Family. And let's talk about celebrity birthdays as we show off our hunk of the day, Ted Cassidy. We've got Megan Nicole, beautiful, gorgeous pop singer, 22 years old today. Chanel West Coast, I love her. She's 27 and a gift sent from heaven. And she's a reality star and she's really hot. And a former baby today on Baron Song of the Day. Yeah, baby. Yeah. Dr. Phil McGraw, how about that? Remember him from Oprah Winfrey's show? Then he had his own show. A lot of people don't like Dr. Phil. I've always liked Dr. Phil, to be honest with you. He's got a lot of good points. I do. I like Dr. Phil, and I think he gets a bad rap. Dr. Phil's a senior citizen now. He's 65 years old today. Tim Kennedy. I like this guy. MMA fighter Tim Kennedy, 36 years old today. Tish Cyrus. Worst thing she ever did was give birth to Miley. Yep, that's right. Miley Cyrus's mom, Tish. 56 years old. And she's kind of a dish, too. Look at Ted Cassidy back then. Oh, my God. What a studly young man, indeed. Gloria Estefan. Oh, my God. You talk about an ageless wonder. She's fine. She's gorgeous. Incredible singer. Gloria Estefan, 58 and looking great and doing great. Rocky Marciano. He whooped Joe Louis's ass. That's right. He whooped Joe Louis's ass. Mm-hmm. Rocky Marciano, the Brockton blockbuster from Brockton, Massachusetts. That guy, retired undefeated, born in the state in 1923, passed away at the much too young age of 46 in 1969. Conway Twitty, born Harold Jenkins, phenomenal country singer, originally a rockabilly singer. Conway Twitty, born in the state in 1933, passed away in 1993 at the much too young age of 59. Yes, Lurch actually came out with a record album. I'm not kidding. I gotta get this album. I do. Play it on Baron Song of the Day. Lily Tomlin, actress. She's 76 years old today. And we'll talk about September 1st, 1939 shortly. Because the day Lily Tomlin was born, some interesting things happened. Look at that. How about that? Ted Cassidy from Star Trek, the original series. Awesome stuff. I know, Justin Dimmitt, you like that, don't you? You're damn right. And I know you know it, too, because nobody knows Star Trek more than you do. Former Major League ball player, predominantly with the Atlanta Braves. Rico Cardi, 76 years old today as well. Barry Gibb, the oldest of the Bee Gees. Sadly, the only Gibb brother that's alive. The oldest of the four Gibb brothers. He's 69 years old today. Tim Hardaway, NBA badass basketball player. Tim Hardaway, 49 years old today. The late, great Bam Bam Bigelow of WWE, WWF, ECW wrestling. Big fan of him. And not NWO and NWA. Well, yeah, he might have been there too. WCW wrestling. Bam Bam Bigelow. Born in the state in 1961. Passed away at the much young age of 45 years old in 2007. Yvonne DiCarlo. Oh, yeah. From the Munsters, of course. The mother on the Munsters. Yvonne DiCarlo, her and her giant bosom. Born in the state 1922. Passed away
At the age of 84, 85 years old in 2007, Nathan McKinnon of the Colorado Avalanche, phenomenal hockey player. He is just a measly 20 years old today. He can't even drink adult beverages, but he's making millions of dollars. Number one overall draft pick with the Colorado Avalanche and Rookie of the Year winner. Calder Trophy, if I'm not mistaken. Sidney Rice, Seattle Seahawks wide receiver, 29 years old today, former Minnesota Viking. There you go. There's your celebrity birthdays. We finish off strong with our man, who can grow an epic mustache, or he did back in those days, Ted Cassidy. Lurch. You rang. Boy, that's a scary looking guy. But I was reading, apparently he was really and truthfully a very gentle giant. A very nice man indeed. Let's drink. Time for our first song of the day. And my dear beloved Mindy Suliotis, you asked for it, you requested it, for your Jeep Patriot, Black Betty, we bring out Black Betty by Ram Jam 1977. As we bring out today's first babe of the day on Baron Song of the Day, she's only 3'11". That's right, big tall guys and little midget hotties. Yeah. This is a lady that is a midget stripper, and she's hooked up with a... He's actually a man that's in the U.S. Army. And they absolutely love each other, an incredible couple. This, my friend, is Kat Hoffman. Kat the Midget Stripper, K-A-T. Black Betty, there you go, Mindy. And our first favorite of the day, she's a cutie, only 3 feet 11 inches tall, 47 inches of awesomeness. Not afraid to show it either. She's a cutie. And there she is with her man. They're a happy couple. He's 6 feet tall like me, a 6-footer. And she's 3'11". 25 inches apart. But their hearts are very big for each other. Hey! If they're happy, leave it alone. Who cares, right? That's the way I look at it. I think she's cute. I don't know if I could be with a midget personally. It's nothing against midgets. I got nothing against little people at all. I got nothing against big people at all. I don't care. It's what's in here that counts, folks. What's in here, and of course to represent the Boston Red Sox too. But you know, she's a cutie, and he's happy, she's happy, they're happy. I'd be happy too. Shoot, I wouldn't kick her out of bed for eating crackers. If I was single, of course. Aww, party time. Yeah. And this says, bite size. Oh, that's epic. Finger tattoos that say bite size. And I thought Elwood and Jake from the Blues Brothers had cool ass finger tattoos, you know? Listen to that, Black Betty, Ram Jam, great song. By the way, this is the full version. 4+ minutes, as opposed to the 2 minute and whatever version. I grabbed the full version. Gotta go big or go home, okay? Interesting picture right there. So cute. Justin Dimmitt, this is for you. She's DSH. I know you know what that means. DS height. You already get it. I don't do acronyms. You do. You already got it when I said DSH. DS height. I'm going to leave it alone from there. Dwarf stripper supported by loving fiance. Awesome. Wicked awesome. Great song. Great babe of the day, a Baron song of the day. Hey, maybe someday I'll have midget men and super wicked tall women. I think it's a great idea. What do you think, fans? I want to know. Comment section below. Hit me up. If you want to see that, let me know. If you don't want to see it, let me know. Either way, you get active, get involved, comment what you want. I'm going to give you a shout out on the show either way, no matter what. Because that means you're watching the show, you're paying attention. Tape over the nerps. Aww. Free the nipple. I support the free the nipple movement, okay? I do. So yeah, let's drink. Time for our hunk of the day on beer and song of the day. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start reading this day in history because I got tons of this day in history. The first day of the month is usually full of history. So with that said, this guy right here, Justin Dimmitt, I got to confess, I was not familiar with him. He played Lurch in the Addams Family movie, and he's also been in Star Trek and among other things. Carol, C-A-R-E-L, interesting, Stroykin, S-T-R-U-Y-C-K-E-N. Not the most handsome looking fellow in the world, folks. In my opinion. But he's a hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day, and that's something that Justine Bieber will never be able to say, because Justine Bieber's a babe of the day, but will never be a hunk of the day. This guy right here is 7 feet tall on the money. A 7-footer. I don't know, his head has unique indentations. Hey, just think, ladies, you can grab him like this and, you know. Ugh. So, yeah. Carol Stroykin. He's 66, 67 years old now. I heard he's a phenomenally nice guy. I believe it. I don't doubt it. Always doing autograph sessions. All right, a lot of cool things happen on this day, September 1st in the year of our Lord, whenever. Let me ask you a question, Guido. Did you know about this? Baltimore Browns, formerly the original Cleveland Browns. I said Baltimore Browns. I should be shot for saying that. They tried to have the Baltimore Browns. And Cleveland said, hell no. Cleveland said, eh. Good on you, Cleveland. The Baltimore Ravens, formerly the Cleveland Browns, hence the slip-up, had their first NFL game. They beat the Oakland Raiders 17-14. August 8, 1995, New York City reinstates the death penalty. Good. Some people deserve to die. August 8, 1995 as well. Rock and Roll Hall of Fame officially opens in Cleveland, Ohio. Awesome stuff. I gotta go there someday. There he is from Star Trek. August 8, 1990, 25 years ago today, the day my good friend Derek Reardon was born. Highest combined Canadian Football League score, 111 points. The Toronto Argonauts beat the British Columbia Lions 68-43. Wow! August 8, 1987, 15-year-old Michael Chang of the United States, youngest man to win a U.S. Open, or United States Tennis Open match. I think it was U.S. Open. He won a match, and youngest to ever do that. August 8, 1982, maximum speedometer reading was put on automobiles at 85 miles per hour. We know that's changed since then, thankfully. But that was back in the day of the 55 mile per hour national speed limit, 85 mile per hour max speed limit. Max reading, that's some crap. August 8, 1979. I wonder why his head's sunken in. Los Angeles court orders Clayton Moore, the Lone Ranger, to stop wearing a Lone Ranger mask. They literally told Clayton Moore, who was the Lone Ranger in the 1949 to 1957 TV series, to stop wearing the Lone Ranger mask. Frickin' California, the land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Western Nevada. That is so weak. RSA 1978, the last broadcast of Columbo on NBC TV. Odyssey in 1977, first Trash 80, that's what it was known as, first TRS 80 Model 1 computer is sold. Radio Shack. Odyssey 1975, 40 years ago today, something the United States ought to consider thinking about. All political parties forbidden in Bangladesh. You know, maybe if we got rid of the two-party system in the United States, our country might be just a little bit more divided. I mean, can't get any more divided than it already is. A little bit more united. We could become the United States of America again. Also on this day in 1975, a very sad day, after 20 seasons, Gunsmoke aired its last episode, Resign the Air. Very sad day indeed. Gunsmoke, phenomenal TV series for 20 years. On this day in 1972, Bobby Fischer of the United States defeats Boris Spassky of the Soviet Union for the world chess title. I believe that was the first American to win the chess title. Of course, Bobby Fischer, we know how jacked up in the head that guy was. On this day in 1971, Qatar declares independence from Great Britain. Happy Independence Day, 44 years ago today. Qatar. Some people say it Qatar. I think it's Qatar. I don't know. I don't care. On this day in 1965, big day for Japanese baseball players. Masanori Murakami, first Japanese player to reach the major leagues. He did it with the New York Mets. Awesome stuff. Big milestone day, 51 years ago today. On this day in 1962, United Nations announces the population of Earth has officially hit 3 billion people. Folks, we're over 7 billion people. So think about it. Probably, that was 53 years ago, so given another 53 years, we're probably going to be at 12 billion people, most likely. Pretty impressive. On this day in 1962, United Nations, I already read that. On this day in 1955, Hurricane Carol strikes Long Island and New England. My father remembers this storm well. Sadly, it killed 68 people. There's our last hunk of the day. We need to get this last song of the day. I wanted to get this show under 40 minutes. It ain't gonna happen. It's gonna be close. For you, Mindy Suliotis, and your 2010 Ford Escape, we bring Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds, Beatles 1967. Let's bring out our final babe of the day on Baron Song of the Day. She's a cutie. She's only 4 feet tall, 48 inches of power. Terre Jolie, J-O-L-E. Lovely lady, 35 years old. Oh, cleavage, French for cleavage. Let's drink. The most famous song, album, of course, 1967, Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds. From their album, Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. She's got a baby. That means she does it. On this day in 1949, first network detective series premieres on television, Private Eyes. Also on this day in 1949, KMTV TV Channel 3, Omaha, Nebraska, the cornhole state. CBS, later NBC affiliate, begins broadcasting. On this day in 1948, United Nations World Health Organization forms. On this day in 1946, impersonation of Britney Spears, but cuter. First U.S. Women's Open Golf Championship is won by the legendary Patty Berg. On this day in 1939, a horrible day indeed, not because Rico Cardi and Lily Tomlin was born, but because that douchebag Adolf Hitler orders extermination of mentally ill people. There's a few that deserve to die, but not many, okay? But Germany invaded Poland, takes Danzig. World War II officially has begun. On this day in 1906, the New York Highlanders, later to be known as the New York Yankees, they win their sixth game in 3 days from Washington, the original Washington Senators. Three straight doubleheaders, six games won in 3 days. Not good if you're a Senators fan. On this day in 1905, Alberta and Saskatchewan in Canada become the 8th and 9th Canadian provinces, eh? Cool. Happy 110th birthday. On this day, 1902, the best double play combination in Major League history, Tinker to Evers to Chance, Chicago Cubs, they appeared together for the first time ever. On this day in 1890, first baseball tripleheader, Boston versus Pittsburgh. We're talking to Boston Braves and Pittsburgh Pirates, folks. On this day in 1878, the first female telephone operator starts work. I'm not making this shit up. Her name, Emma Nutt. Emma Nutt. You have to be a nut to be a telephone operator. I could not do that job, folks. E-M-M-A-N-U-T-T, Boston, Massachusetts. August 1867, Robert T. Freeman, first black person to graduate from Harvard Dental School. Awesome. August 1799, Bank of Manhattan Company opens in New York City. They are the forerunner to Chase Manhattan. August 1772, Mission San Luis Obispo de Tolosa forms in California. Je ne parle pas espagnol très bien. That's French for saying I don't speak Spanish very well, because I can say that. August 1752, Liberty Bell arrives in Philadelphia. Yeah. August 1689, Russia begins taxing men's beards, folks. They put a tax on beards. That's some bullshit. Taxing a beard. Jeez. What a cheap way to make a buck. Sounds like something the United States of America would do. August 1666, a sad day indeed. The Great London Fire begins. In Pudding Lane. Interesting. Sadly, 80% of London was destroyed. August 1661, that's the last picture of the day. August 1661, the first yacht race. England's King Charles versus his brother James. Don't even mention who won. Come on, brainyhistory.com. I wanted to know who won that one. It only happened back in 1661, but damn it, I want to know who won. I could Google it, I guess. Let's drink shit. And finally on this day, 480 years ago, back in 1535, French navigator Jacques Cartier reaches Hochelaga, H-O-C-H-E-L-A-G-A. I don't know how to pronounce it. But we know it today as Montreal, or as they say in French, Montreal. Montreal, Quebec, Canada. There you go. 480 years ago today, Jacques Cartier discovered it. Although it was probably discovered by native North Americans prior to that. Let's drink. Let's slam it home. Empty as the brain cells of an average Montreal Canadiens fan, eh? Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, where I'd like to be. Folks, time to make a feed us a head out. So everybody take care. We'll get an awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything when you do. Don't drink and drive, my spirit. Drink all you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is done to being a Yankees fan. And what's dumber than that? Is rooting for a puking fest of goober schnitzels. Like Justine.
Yeah, I should have been swallowed because the United States and Canada both hate me because I'm a total douchebag.
No shit. Beaver. What's dumber than that, though, is men, some women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people who watch on pets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports fans was a member of the Westboro Baptist Church, or ISIS. Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big, fat, GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. See you tomorrow on West Wednesday. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Go Red Sox.